so cute. Is it because it's December?
You know, I think it's because we're both having purple and gray vibes, apparently, with the purple eyes and the gray sweaters and the poof and the bop.
Giving you a moment.
And it was unplanned, so we're like secretly super excited. We're also excited about the subject matter.
We are.
Today we are talking about our projections for CHH for 2020. Mm. We recently did a video where we talked about, we looked back at our projections. Well, not projections, but what we wanted to see in 2019 to kind of see where things stood. And we were pretty, we got a lot of
accurate. We were accurate. If you haven't seen it, go ahead and check it out. Literally dropped that last week, so you definitely want to see that. And now we want to see, what could we imagine happening in 2020? What are the cool things that CHH could move into and towards in the new year, new decade, new things?
More music in more places. Like, it was great to see, like, we've kind of been on this wave, coming up, hearing songs like Stop Me for Lethal Weapon, and even in Rhythm and Flow, hearing Manolo.
Randomly, I was like, anybody ever catch Manolo?
Yes.
And people jam into it, just regular, regular.
I do it, but it turned, at first it was such an old song, too. I was like, oh my gosh.
Especially gonna get these coins. Come on, Gabby, I swear.
And so I think that we're going to see more CHH in more places in 2020. I know a lot of artists, when they create, this is what they think about. And I think that as we're looking for more ways to monetize and more ways to spread the message in non-traditional ways without it just being mic in my hand in front of a crowd, that's going to be the wave. So I'm going to be looking for your songs on TV shows, in commercials, just everywhere. Sporting things.
They're,
yes.
All over the place. I am projecting or giving the idea of CHH International. I know that there have been forays, and I know that we don't have a lot of crossover. Like, I know that there are Christian hip hop artists in other places. Africa and Europe and Asia, like, they're all over, but we're not hearing a lot of them here in the States. But I know they get a few artists out in their area. Very few, very, not that often, get to go overseas. So I think it would be great to have more CHH crossover and let it be truly international, because the gospel is for the whole world. And so I would love to hear more music from all over the world when it comes to gospel. And I think it'd be really cool to hear more Christian hip hop from all over the place.
So you used to have an Afrobeat summer.
I did.
And that's what
that is all I listened to.
But you know what's funny? I was thinking the same thing. My next point was gonna be more crossovers. I foresee more gospel collaborations in a way where, because normally what we see is gospel song, room for a rapper. Gospel song, room for a rapper. But I'm seeing more rap song, room for a choir. Rap song, room for a choir. Like, I really see it kind of taking that approach where the hip hop piece is a little bit more prominent than it normally is in those kinds of collaborations. So I'm really looking forward to that. I know we have our moments with CCM, but I actually feel like we're gonna see more with gospel. And I don't know if that has something to do with the fact that everybody loved, like, the gospel sounds that were throughout Jesus's King. Now granted, it's not new. Let's just put that out there, because people are ready to be like, this is not the time for that. It's not what we're talking about.
We are aware.
But this is not what we're talking about.
We give our props already.
We're talking about where we are right now. And I think that having a gospel choir come in, it's easier to financially, I think, do like a feature than it is to do a sample. And so I really, unless somebody's really just giving you something, which I mean, come on, not any of these gospel folks. So I'm really seeing, even if it, whether it's a big name or not, I really think that we're going to start seeing more collaborations in that way, where you're getting like more choirs on hip hop songs, more gospel artists on hip hop songs, as opposed to the way it's been before, where it's the other way around.
Ooh, I like that. I just can imagine like a collab album of like really those type of sounds. And I know Kanye was supposed to, but didn't deliver. I think a full album, and not just Kirk, but like other sounds in there. I think that'd be really cool.
I think we're going to see more exclusive kinds of contents and rollouts. You guys are getting really, really creative with the way that you give us things, and y'all completely here for it. We're gonna have more curation, more not just come to my show, hear my raps, there's my merch table. It's gonna be like all of this goes together, and you're gonna wanna experience the this along with the this, but then you gotta get the this, and then it's like a big, it's a thing that mm-hmm. goes together.
Yeah.
And even prior to Jesus came, we're not calling Kanye a pioneer of any of this. I'm just saying, when I think about what I have seen over the course of the year, we still have people who release music traditionally too, but what I've seen over the course of the year is a lot more like, how can I roll this out in a way that my fans would really appreciate it and feel like they were a part of something?
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like we'll start to see more of that. There are already some artists who are doing incredible things with that. We've talked about Ruslan before and his the way that he does things. And John Keith kind of follows in that same vein. We talked about Armand Wake Up and how he does his rollouts and how it's just very different. And I look at even Andy. And
yeah,
I
think, had a whole podcast to go along with the rollout.
Yes,
so I think that was super cool.
It. And I feel like we're going to start seeing a lot of different things, and we're going to start engaging in your art in a different way. And I'm, listen, come with it.
And I think that I would like to see, and I think that's probably going to happen in 2020, are like Christian music festivals.
It is time.
It's time, like a festival. And I know that Kirk has Exodus, which is like a gospel music festival, but that happens in Texas, and I haven't been able to make it. But I think it would be really cool to have a Christian hip hop festival. And I think we kind of had like a feel of what that would look like at I3C with Rapzilla, just knowing what like one show it would look like. But I think it would be very cool to be able to get everyone together in Atlanta, gotta put it out there, so that it could be like a full weekend of acts and talks and...
Yes. Think of it like a Legacy meets like PIA meets A3C.
Right, but like Legacy, but not the talks, just like...
Yeah.
But like just the how much of it is.
I think it would be great.
And put the poets in there. It's all the same culture.
But I think it would be great to do it not just from a... hey, we're here to be evangelized too, but I think it would be really great if it was like a, this is the state of affairs of the culture and the industry, and let's have conversations that help shape that, where we have the people who are participating in it on the poetry side, or the music side, or the executive side, or the label side, or even the fan side. We get to collaboratively come together and talk about, this is where CHH is. This is what we want CHH to do. It could be really be like a meeting of the minds.
Ooh, I love that.
I would super, I'm like, what is the cost? Doesn't matter.
Forget it, cost. You know us. Pay you it. Want us to be there. You
yes.
want us to be hosting a part of it, hosting one of these panels.
Yes.
I was like, girl, the vision is us in the building.
Yes.
I think I would like more, not necessarily experimental, but more small artistic settings where you maybe have like artist and a painter and like a small artistic opening moment, just because that's the type of thing that I like to go to, like art shows and art openings. And I'd love for it to be a little bit more varied in the things that we like to do. I think we need to like really expand the idea of nightlife, Christian nightlife, and have like little artsy things that really speak to the culture and where we're at. And we're at a place where we're like, I want to go to like a little art show.
Yes.
I want to go to a little open mic. I want to go to a little
artists.
Acoustic thing. And I know there's people who can do that. You can just collab and go, you know, here is a bunch of my art that I was going to do an exhibit for anyway. Do you want to come through and do a little acoustic set at the same time? Yes. I love acoustic hip hop.
And that's the thing.
No,
because you know what? What is wild to me about this is that I don't know what Sarita's experience is like in her seat right now. But every time she says something, I'm like, my gosh, I was just about to say that. So I'm like, I was gonna say more stripped down, unplugged style concerts.
Yes, unplugged was the move.
You know, because I feel like, you know, we have bounce around. We got plenty of that. Okay, okay, it's fine. We're not knocking it. But I'm just saying, I can see somebody like a prop.
Mm-hmm.
I can see a Derek Minor. Maybe for this joint album, like, do it, please. Do it. I can even see a Jackie. I can see so many artists coming and just doing like a, I'm standing and I'm rapping in this smaller venue and we get an opportunity to interact. But you get a really engaged room though. Not like a room that's gonna be like, but a room that's really gonna be fully engaged. And I think that would be a great experience that you could even like film. Like,
okay, you could sell that.
I would love to see just something like that. There's so many artists that come to mind that I think could really do something like that. Mm-hmm. Have a forum, talk, chop it up, like really have an unplugged kind of moment. I would absolutely be at that show.
Oh, all day.
Put me in the front. Like, ooh, I'll be at that show.
I want that.
Yes.
It's in my veins.
Yeah. But I really look forward to seeing things like that and artists taking their shows to a different level. Like we talked about last year when we wanted to see the production value go up, but we did. You guys have gotten the lights. We even got a little pyrotechnic moment. Like, we've seen the things. But now I'm just like, keep that same energy for sure. But I also think even stripping it down is not taking that away, but it's saying, let me create an experience that my fans can walk away from saying like, dang, we really like, we're a part of something. Mm-hmm. And so it makes me think of like when we went to Sean David Grant's private release for his album Wonder Years, and how he really was just like, there's some food over there. And he really had somebody who was, you see what I said? You see what I did there, right? You fed us. And but it was like, I mean, I'm kidding, you don't have to do that. But
have food available, you don't have to.
Yeah, and that's the thing, because a lot of times
free, just have it there.
I will say this, a lot of times we go to these concerts and there are no concessions, so we would like to see concessions at the concerts, please, because we'd be out there for hours and there are literally no concessions. So yeah, since I was going somewhere too,
like, Sean was like,
it was yes, and it was like a moment, like he just had somebody on an acoustic guitar, somebody singing in the background, and it was a real casual thing, but it got me into all of the songs and I heard all the lyrics clearly. And I was like, that was really a moment. I would like to see more things like that where it's like an experience is being put together and we get to walk away feeling like we were part of something.
That's it. That's all I'm going to give you this time, guys. I'm trying to not give you a super duper long video.
Yes. Our 2019 video
was long. We had to suffer through it. You're like, that was like 15 minutes of this?
I died.
Who are these girls? Why you let them keep talking?
Exactly. So we're like, this time we're like, we're gonna just.
If I have to watch this again at the end of 2020, then I need to be like, oh, okay, cool, 580.
So guys, we would love to hear your projections as well, your ideas as well for what you think CHH is gonna look like next year, or things that you want to see, things that you don't want to see. Like, why not? Let's do
right,
it.
Right.
And drop it in the comments. Let us know so we can definitely talk with you, laugh with you, and maybe hopefully not shoot down any dreams.
I'm not trying to shoot down dreams. I think it's going to be, if you guys are interested in those types of things as well.
Got it.
Definitely drop it in the comments. Let us know what other crazy, interesting, artistic views you have. And even if it's not CHH, if you're an artist in a different way, and you're like, for me in 2020, my goals are blah, 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 blah. Go ahead and drop it below. We believe in accountability.
Yes.
We'll be holding you down over here.
Exactly. And if you're liking this video, please be sure to like it, hit the thumbs up, and also hit the bell. Get those notifications when the videos drop and subscribe to our channel. Get in there.
Subscribe.
Yes. And until next time.
Have a good time.
Bye.